beautiful friends, and welcome back to my channel. This is Nova Gnome Creations, and I'm Nova, and I am so happy to see you today. I hope that you are doing well, and I hope that you and your loved ones are taking care of the best that you can. I hope that you guys had a fantastic weekend. I was feeling a little under the weather on Friday, and I had said that in my video, and some of you guys had said that you hoped I feel better, and I just want to say a big thank you. I am feeling quite a bit better. I spent the weekend with my hubby. Alan Wake 2 came out. So for any of you in the gaming community, you may know that game. It has been 13 years since the first game came out, so it has been a long-awaited game that we weren't really sure we were going to get for a long time. So it's been very, very fun and exciting to get to play that game. It also has, like, my favorite band, probably, in the game. They're called Poets of the Fall. You should totally look them up. They're a really, really good band. I would say that they are possibly my favorite band. I don't like to pick favorites when it comes to things like music, or books or things like that, because I just have so many that I love, but they are definitely a contender for my favorite. But in the universe of Alan Wake, they are the Old Gods of Asgard, which is a rock band. And Alan Wake is kind of a... I think it's technically classified as like a horror game, but it is very, very different than like your average horror game. I wouldn't consider it anything like any other horror game. It has a really like complex story, and I love like a really complex story like that because I love to theorize as I watch things or play things. I love to come up with running theories of what's going on with the plot. And I love a story that can keep me on my toes and constantly switch things up so that I can't figure it out. And I don't know. Like, I'll make a theory and then I'm like, well, maybe not. Maybe it's this, you know? Because I am, like, really good at figuring out what's going on. So a lot of times when I'm watching a movie or something, I will figure out the plot really quickly. Like, what's all going to happen and everything. And I don't necessarily want to be able to do that, but I do like to theorize. So it has a really good storyline, really great characters. So that has been awesome.
So something that you may not know is that the game Alan Wake and also the band Poets of the Fall are both Finnish. They're both made by Finnish people. And so when we were playing, I spotted on the table this Finnish pastry type thing called Karjalan piirakka. It is, or also maybe known as a Karelian pie, but it is a Finnish, like, traditional food that I haven't had since I was in Finland, which coincidentally was also 13 years ago when I was there for foreign exchange. So I decided that we needed to have some to go with our gaming, and I made some. I didn't have rye flour though, so I did substitute whole wheat. They came out really good. I was so happy. I also made an egg butter to put on top of them, and hubby absolutely loved it also, which made me super happy. So definitely going to be something that I make again, and I will definitely have to get some rye flour too.
What we do is hubby has been playing, and while he was playing, I was, you know, backseat gaming, pointing out things, making theories, you know, helping him solve the puzzles and things like that. But I also was crocheting. And what was I crocheting? Well, you know, something completely different and not a whip that I have talked about at all, because literally Friday, my husband asked me to make a Snom. So if you guys know anything about Pokemon, you might know what Snom is. Snom is a newer Pokemon, so you might not know. I will pop a picture up right here of what Snom looks like. Snom is a very funny looking little Pokemon. It was so funny, actually. I sent a picture to my siblings and my sister goes, "It looks like a butt." And I said, "Yeah, it definitely does. It's got a butt face, but it's cute. It's so cute." So my hubby has been like, "Yes, I want a Snom." And he was just like sending me pictures and GIFs of Snoms on Friday. So I was like, "You know what? I'll make you a Snom." So that was my task to myself. And I will go more into what ended up happening as far as the pattern and everything goes when I actually... Okay, I was about to pull this in here, and then now there's a little hair stuck on here. Oh my gosh, why am I like this? It's stuck in the fibers, and there we go. And this type of chenille yarn, if you like pick at it, you can like pick the chenille like yarn off of it. So if you're just like pulling off little tufts of yarn. Okay, so putting this over to the side because I was not ready to pull that in quite yet. I will go more in detail like about what all happened with the pattern and all that good stuff when I actually finish it, but I did want to show you guys what it's looking like so far. So, I did attempt to make the bottom of it flat. It looks very stubby right now because it doesn't have the spikes. This is going to be all covered in big spikes. Big icy spikes. But here is what it looks like. It's got little tiny eyes, and its little tiny, and its little butt face. And I did attempt to make the bottom of this flat in an interesting way. I tried to get creative with it by sewing something inside of here. But like I said, I'll go more in details of how I constructed it and all of that good jazz when I actually finish it. But it is huge. So this is what I was working on the whole time that we've been having our weekend, and it is double-stranded velvet yarn and chenille yarn. The chenille is the white and the blue is velvet yarn. And then I double-stranded them with worsted weight yarns, white and then a really light, like mint, it's mint blue, sparkle. So it actually is sparkly also, which I think is perfect for kind of that snowy effect. But yes, it is a very large boy, and it's not even done because I'm working on the spikes for it right now. And let's just say I didn't think this through very well. Because part of the reason that I am double stranding it is because the blue that I had in the plushier type of yarn is not the right shade of blue for Stom. So I was like, okay, I could use this blue, but lighten it up by double stranding it with a lighter color. So I was like, okay, I use this blue, double stranded it with a really light mint, and it makes a kind of lighter shade of blue sort of effect. But I'm having an issue that I am running out of yarn. And I hope I don't run out of yarn before I finish it. So here's one of the spikes, and this is, I believe, the largest spike. It's gonna go in the middle, and then there's gonna be like in the middle of the front, and then on the sides there'll be two slightly smaller, and then down even further on the sides, two even smaller. But then there's like three rows of that, and like smaller spikes all up in the back. So there's gonna be a lot of spikes, and I just didn't think about the fact that like these bigger spikes are basically like small amigurumis of their own, like in size. So it's taking quite a bit of yarn. So yeah, I am running very low on yarn, and I don't know if this is all I've got left of this blue. I don't know if this is gonna be enough to finish these spikes. Because I had a lot of it, but I worked my way through it. And actually, this mint that I'm using was a completely new skein from my yarn haul that I showed you guys. And even it's looking very thin and floppy. I've used quite a lot of it. And these come with 380 yards. Let's put it this way, too, to give some context. The whites that I used, I'm double stranding that same twinkle yarn, but in white. Double stranding it with the white just chenille Dollar Tree yarn. You know, it comes in the smaller little skeins. I have used almost two skeins of those little chenille yarns. So, quite the big chonker here. But that's what I was working on this weekend. And I do have a finished item to show you guys as well. I finished this last week, but I just didn't have time to show it in my last week videos. But I made a little baby Hexie Cardi for my niece that is not born yet. I wanted to do kind of fall palette for it, kind of, I say a fall palette, but it's an earth tone palette, because my sister is obsessed with these colors. These are like her jam. And we're doing, or she's doing, the nursery in a Hobbit theme. So I thought it would be cute for like maybe some little pictures when she's small, to have some like clothes that go with the theme, you know? So I'm gonna make some other cute things. I'm thinking I might make like a romper or like a little dress or something like that. But something really easy to make is these little hexagon cardigans. And I was like, I could make her a tiny hexagon cardigan in these kind of earth tone shades. So I love how it came out. I love it. I love it. And then I gave it a little pocket and put my tiny toadstool applique that I made a tutorial for. I put one of those on here. So it even has a tiny pocket for her to store her tiny belongings, you know. Let's see, what have I got over here that's small? I've got this tiny penguin. She could stick a little penguin in her pocket. It's flocked, so it's like getting stuck. But yes, it has a tiny little functional pocket. I think this is the cutest thing ever. And what I ended up doing was I went to Target and I bought a 0 to 3 month romper. That way I could size tops or bottoms or onesies or rompers off of it, so that I can get a good like reference for sizing. So this is in a 0 to 3 months kind of estimate on my estimations, and lining it up and everything. Think it came out so cute. I used a mandala cake in the colorway of Groot for most of this, and then this was a scrap yarn that I used for this round that has like the teal, or not the teal. Well, yeah, I would say that's teal. So it's got like it's variegated, so it's got like two different shades of teal coming through, and like red and orange kind of rusty colors. And then I used Red Heart Roll With It Melange for the cuffs. So it's got little cuffs on it too. And I love it so much. I think it came out so cute. And now I kind of want to make more baby hexagon cardigans because I had so much fun making this one. And oh yeah, and I trimmed it in Red Heart Roll With It Melange also. So all around the front and all around the bottom, I trimmed it with that. So I love how that came out. I think it came out so cute. So I might make some more little hexagon cardigans. She's gonna be born in February next year, and so it's gonna be cold. It's also gonna be in Michigan. So like February in Michigan is really cold. Like basically the coldest month of the year is January, I believe, up there. So February is very, very cold. Not that, you know, she's a tiny baby. Not that she's gonna be like outside really, but like, I don't know. I think she needs like a stock of hexagon cardigans in all the different colors now because I had fun making this one and I can just imagine her being all tiny and adorable wearing one. So, that's what I was working on like last week, and then that was what I was working on over the weekend. As far as community spotlight goes, I didn't have it on Friday because I ended up just posting that yarn haul that I had already filmed the night before or the day before. I am going to do what I'm thinking would be fun, is tomorrow is Halloween. I was thinking let's have a Halloween party, like a community Halloween party. So, I'm gonna do like a big community spotlight bash tomorrow. We'll do a Halloween themed video. I have got my Halloween wreath finished that I had talked to you guys about and showed you a little bit of. So I can include pictures of how there pictures and video clips of how I went about finishing it and what it looks like now, how it came out. Maybe I'll do some dressing up. I have no idea what as yet, but just something fun to do for Halloween. And if you guys want to, you know, get any of your little spooky stuffs on or out, you can feel free to join me. Make sure you send in your makes for Community Spotlight, especially if you have any Halloween makes, because we're going to have a big old Halloween bash tomorrow and lots of Community Spotlight goodness. And then as far as Gnome of the Month goes, I will probably go ahead and do my Gnome of the Month reveal on Saturday, because I can just go ahead and have Gnome of the Month and tell you guys plans for November's Gnome of the Month in the same video. So I'll just kind of combine the Gnome of the Month reveal video and the Gnome of the Month announcement video, because I have still not actually finished my mermaid gnome, but I am working on it and it is coming along great, but I still have a little bit of work to go on it. And I don't want to, like, you know, pressure myself, try to get it done like super, super quick. But I think I could finish it by Saturday, no problem. So I was thinking we can do our Gnome of the Month Saturday. So if you guys are wanting to send in your gnome makes from this last month, feel free to do that as well. If you are sending in Community Spotlight stuff or Gnome of the Month stuff, you guys know the drill, but just in case you don't know the drill, real quick, you send me an email, which my email is always in the description box of all of my videos, but it is novagnomecreations@gmail.com. You send me an email, and then in the subject line of your email, you put Community Spotlight or Gnome of the Month. In your email, you can say anything that you want. Just make sure that you let me know what name you would like me to credit you with when I put together my video. I'm going to put together a video montage. It's going to have like video clips and pictures and all that good jazz. So you can attach as many pictures as you want to your email. You can send in as many makes as you want. I don't put a limit on that. And as long as it's something that you made, you can send in anything. So I don't require it to be crochet. I don't even require it to be fiber art. As long as it is something crafty that you have made, something artsy, something crafty, something like that you came up with, you are welcome to send that in. I've had people send in things like diamond paintings, cross stitching, things that they've done with their Cricut, tie dye. You could do paintings or sculptures or things that you make out of clay that are not sculptures. I'm not sure. You know, there's a lot of variety of things you could do. So obviously for Gnome of the Month, it would be things that are gnomey. Community Spotlight, though, anything crafty. So you can send those in. And if you are new here and this is your first time here, welcome. This is my cozy little corner of YouTube. So I hope that you feel super comfy cozy while you're here. We kind of have a little bit of a corner vibe going on now in the background too. So it kind of lends itself. But the cozy little corner of YouTube that we have here, it is our Gnomey corner. And if you are here watching this video, then you are part of my community. And that means you're a Gnomey, which means that you can participate in our Community Spotlights and our Gnome of the Month and all that good jazz. And it also means that when you are here, you can come into the cozy little corner. You can leave your worries with the doorman, which we are in the process of coming up with a name for. Got a couple good contenders on the board right now. Feel free to leave your ideas if you have any ideas for our doorman to be called, but you can leave your worries with him and he stashes them in the back for you. You can choose when you leave the cozy little corner if you would like to pick up your worries or if you'd rather just leave them with him and not worry about them anymore. You can just leave them with him. But I understand that sometimes you have things that are legitimate worries that you need, you know, to take care of, things that you are concerned about for a good reason, but you still need and deserve a break from worrying about these things. You know, maybe it's an important thing that needs to be taken care of and your concern is totally valid. That doesn't mean that you can just shoulder that burden all the time. And sometimes, a lot of times, our worries are not something we need to be carrying around. And then you can just leave them. But come in, take a deep breath, pick out your favorite chair, and that's the magic of the cozy little corner. It can literally be anything. So imagine the most comfy, cozy seat you could possibly imagine. It can be a real thing. It could be like a couch or a chaise lounge or a waterbed, but it could also be like a cloud. Like, this is a very magical little place, and you just come in here and have like a moment of reprieve. Sit down, take a deep breath, grab something yummy to drink, grab a project maybe, and hang out and just chill. Just hang out with me, let go of everything else that's going on around you in the world that's stressing you out. not while you're here. So if you are new here, I hope that this will be that place for you. And if you're not new here, I absolutely hope that this is the place that you do that. I was going to say, I hope this is the place for you. But if you're not new here and you're here, this is obviously the place for you because you are here. I just want to say a huge thank you to you guys for coming back time and time again. It means the absolute world to me. You guys are literally my best friends and I love you guys so much. You make everything all worth it and I'm really, really grateful to have you guys in my life. Just a little update for Community Blanket Project. I have worked up, let me grab this little note. I have worked up like a little concept of the sizing. So you guys know how I was telling you that I needed to work up, I'm going to work up panels. Since everybody's sending in all their squares for the Community Blanket Project, which I will link down below in case you don't know what I'm talking about, there's a video about this so that you can get filled in. I'll link it in the description box below this video. But since everybody's sending in their squares and their different sizes and stuff, then what I'm going to do is they're not going to line up perfectly, but I'm going to make it all come together and work up. And the way that I'm going to do that is I'm going to work up squares, like big squares. I decided 20 inch squares. And that gives me a smaller space to work with to, kind of collage everything together so it fits nicely. And then I can fill in the little gaps with either, I can either crochet little tiny squares to fill in the gaps, or I could put borders on some of the squares to fill in the gaps, you know, things like that. Just kind of get creative with it. Make these 20 inch squares, and then at the end, or when I get further into it, I could go as do it as I go if I want to. I can attach the 20 inch squares together and it will make our blanket. So I came up with the plan based off of a king size blanket, but it could also be a smaller blanket. I wanted the concept to be with the biggest blanket possible that we would make in mind. I have a king size bed, and since this is going to be like staying here and it's going to be my blanket after we finish it, it would be cool if it was the size of my bed, but I have absolutely no like illusions that we're going to get enough squares to make a king size blanket. But like I said, I want to make sure that we have it all figured out for like however big it comes out. So it's a king size blanket is 60 by 80 inches. So like I said, I mathed that out so that you would have 20 by 20 squares, three of them, by five of them or four of them. Sorry, I'm trying to look at it in my reflection here. Yeah, so three of them by four of them, but very easily could just not add on another row here. And it would be, you know, three by three, that would make a square blanket, which would be totally awesome too. So that is kind of where we're going with that. And now that I've figured this out, I am going to start to work on putting squares together too. So, I've got a lot of things going on. Working on quite a few things actually. Oh, and I did get yarn for this thing I am making for my other niece, my niece that is going to be turning one in November. She is into this thing called Badanamu. It's like a little TV show thing on YouTube, and in it there is this character called Mimi, and it is like kind of like a bean, kind of looks like a bean, and it's got like little legs too. So this is going to be the body. I've got the little legs made, but I haven't attached them yet. But I realized after starting this project, I did not have yellow in chenille yarn, and I wanted to do the belly patch in yellow in chenille yarn. So I was able to find some yellow. This is the Baby Bee Adorable in Bumblebee Wings. Looks very, very soft and buttery. It's like a very pastel-y sort of sweet yellow. Yeah, the colorway is Bumblebee Wings. So I think that this will be really cute. And this was actually the only yellow they had in chenille yarn, so it worked out really well that this was like the perfect shade. And if you guys don't know, Hobby Lobby is the only local yarn store that I have. The only other place that I would have that is kind of local is or not kind of local, it's kind of yarn-ish, is Walmart. But they definitely don't carry, I don't think, any chenille yarn. And then my Dollar Tree never has chenille yarn. I know they're supposed to have the premier yarns, the just yarn worsted, just yarn sport, just chenille, you know, all of those. Mine currently doesn't even have any premier yarn. I don't know what is up with that, but like they did have just the like just yarn worsted, but they never would get the freaking chenille yarn. Now they don't even have that. They just went back to Crafter's Square, which that yarn is like not a vibe. It is like, I don't like the texture of it. It doesn't come in very many colors. It's like, eh. Anyway, so that is what I've got going on. I've got a lot of things going on in my little crochet world here, guys. And that's only some of the things. Anyways, let me know what you guys are up to. Make sure you're here tomorrow for our little Halloween party. And if you'd like to send in anything for Community Spotlight, if you dressed up, feel free to send in a picture of you in your costume, or if you dressed up your pet or your kids, or your grandkids, and you want to share pictures of them, feel free to send them to me, same way that you normally would. Make sure you put Community Spotlight as the subject line, and I will include those in tomorrow's Halloween party video. I hope you guys have a fantastic rest of your day. Let me know what you guys did this weekend, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye, guys! I almost forgot. Don't forget, guys, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. So whenever you see me wearing this pink hat, what do you think of? I hope you think of getting your boobies checked. I hope you think of doing some self-exams, feeling around, feeling for lumps, feeling for anything that feels out of the normal to talk to your doctor about. And if you are of the age or the risk factors that you should be getting a mammogram, I hope that it makes you think, I'm going to go run and make that phone call and schedule that mammogram. All right, guys, bye for real now.